I feel like I need to do a little disclaimer on this video here. Before we fully get into what is the metaverse, what is Web3, I don't want to see a bunch of the comments being like, it's such a stupid thing, why are you even talking about this? I don't know where that voice came from, but I understand there are a lot of people who are super for this and are super against this. Now, I'm not here to tell you what is right and what is wrong, what I am for, what I'm against. I'm just here to share with you the information. So whether you are for or against the metaverse and Web3, I think right now we just all need to be in a stage of education, learning exactly what are these platforms, what are we speaking about, what are people speaking about when they say Web3, what are they speaking about when they say metaverse, and from there make an educated decision on if you're into it or if you aren't. There isn't one right way or one wrong way, but I think people are just being really closed-minded and just shutting things down really quickly without even understanding exactly what they are. So today we are going to do just that, talk about what is the metaverse and Web3. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Leave in the comments other videos you want to see, and okay, let's just get right into it. So no surprise, this whole video was based on, there's been so much hype and talk recently around the metaverse and Web3 and blockchain and crypto and I can keep on going on and on. And a lot of people are like, what the heck? This is terrible. And a lot of people are like, this is amazing. And I'm just over here in the camp of, I just want to learn more. So that's what we're doing today. And I also want to say, I'm still learning. So it's not that I'm an expert at this, but I'm just, when there is so much hype and so much talk and so much millions and billions being invested into this, I want to know what's going on. So let's start with the metaverse. The concept of a metaverse, of spending time online in a virtual world, isn't really something new. Think about the platforms we already have where we do just that. Whether you are someone on Roblox, maybe you know someone on Roblox, or even Fortnite. Building characters, then living in this virtual world, it's not really a new concept. So why all of a sudden is this becoming so controversial and so hyped up? Well, I think for one, because people are scared. Because when you think of a metaverse and people start talking about living and working in the metaverse, it can freak you out because it's like, am I gonna spend all my life, all my days, all my hours online or like making virtual friends? I wanna live in the real world. And I think that's one of the areas people get really freaked out about the metaverse. Okay, so the metaverse, when you think of it, you can think that technologies that make up the metaverse can include virtual reality, virtual worlds that exist, that continue to exist, I should say, even when you're not playing, even when you're not part of it. So typically when we think metaverse, as of recently anyways, we think of AR a lot. We think of putting on the goggles and going into this virtual world. But as I mentioned, it doesn't have to be accessed that way. For example, once again, Fortnite and Roblox. Also, when we think of metaverse, you can think of the ways that it will translate into the digital economy, where users can buy, create, and sell goods. You know, for example, Nike just got on board and bought a company for virtual shoes, actually. And they didn't actually announce how much they spent on it, but all of these big companies, Adidas being another one, fashion companies, are getting into virtual clothing because as there are more people getting into the metaverse, they are going to want to dress their characters, dress their mini-me's or whatever you want to call them, very stylish. And this is a huge economy. But the reality is, and I think it's more important than anything to keep in mind, no one really, well, I shouldn't say no one, I'm sure some people do, but the average person doesn't really know what the metaverse, when we speak about it like this, is fully going to look like. What we know at this point in time is there are tons of companies investing millions and millions of dollars into this to kind of see what will happen in it. For example, Facebook, or sorry, let's rephrase that, Meta, thinks that it might mean including fake houses where you can invite your friends to hang out, whereas Microsoft seems to think it could involve more virtual meeting rooms. So at this point, I think the term is still really vague and being explored. Now, I'm not saying you need to be an expert on what the metaverse is, but even having an understanding, virtual worlds, why would people want to do this, especially as we are being more remote and working from home and isolated, it might be nice in a way to feel part of your office again by going in the metaverse and having those virtual meetings. Just saying. Okay, now that we've kind of covered what the metaverse is, let's talk about the blockchain. But before we do that, I need to get some tea. Where is some tea over here? Actually, maybe some coffee. Okay, I'm back. How to get some coffee? You know, it's just been like a long long, long day, but it hasn't been that bad today. I've been talking to you, so it's been good. But as you can see, it is so snowy outside and just like crazy, crazy cold. So welcome to Canada. Okay, let's get back to it. The question we were answering is, what is Web3? So I have some notes here on it because, as I said, I'm not an expert. I'm still learning, but I think it's really important to just like talk through this and learn together. So on my notes here, I have Web3 refers to a potential new iteration of the internet that runs on public blockchain. So what exactly it means from my understanding is when it's running on blockchain, it's decentralized, which means users can access the internet for themselves. They don't need to go through these big companies such as Google, Apple, Facebook, whereas they can just go on their own terms. And also too, you can think of it about the data collection side. So Web3 would protect you more so from the data side by being able to have better privacy, not have to go through all the permissions of, oh, I accept all these permissions from Facebook or from whatever company it is, versus it's decentralized. No one owns it and no one is taking that data from you. Of course, let's be real. At this point, there is no necessarily Web3 that we can access. It's just a concept that is going to be a reality very soon. And kind of thinking about from a perspective of blockchain developers, so many blockchain developers really see a future with this, a better future with this. There are a lot of drawbacks or negatives to it as well. So I'm not saying that Web3 is the end all be all, but rather an alternative. And also too, it's really important to note that when Web3 comes around, it's not just going to replace what we currently have, but I really believe it will run alongside of it. You can't completely get rid of the current web and how we currently use systems, but rather it will slowly over time be integrated. Okay, but one of my questions I had is, what came before Web3? Like, what is Web2 and what is Web1? So I have notes here about that as well. So Web1 covers, you know, the 90s and the early 2000s, which was more decentralized and really was more open source. And then what came along is what we have now, which is Web2. And when you think of Web2, you can think of it more so as the internet today. How did you search something online? Well, you probably used a big company such as Google to do so. How did you speak to your friends online? Well, you probably used a big company such as Facebook to do so, or the Metaverse. Different things like that. That's what we currently have now, where big companies really run the web. So it only makes sense that there's going to be another portion to this and something else will come along. Coffee. What did they say? The liquid drink, the drink of programmers? It's very true. I drink a lot of coffee. Okay, and then the last question I had is, what does Web3 really have to do with the metaverse? Like, why are they talking about both of these so much? And a lot of technologists are saying that Web3 will really help incubate a metaverse or contain a metaverse that is ran on the decentralized blockchain. So the metaverse would be run by a network of computers around the world rather than a few big companies, which when you think about the metaverse and you think of the few big companies that could run it, it's terrifying. Whereas if you think if it was more so built on Web3 or with Web3, it's way less intimidating. It seems like, okay, this could be a lot more friendly and less of these tech companies kind of controlling our data and everything we do. Okay, so that is from what I've learned so far, the metaverse and Web3. And once again, this video isn't to convince you it's a good thing or bad thing. It's just to share with you information of what these two things are, these two buzzwords really are, and what the potential for them are. I hope you found this video really helpful and insightful, and also really friendly. I didn't want to make this video and it become across as very static or dry, but rather just some information that I would share with a friend as I'm continuing to learn about it as well. I'm curious to know though, what are your thoughts on the metaverse and Web3? Leave in the comments below. And remember, just stay open-minded. We are people in technology. It's important to just stay open-minded. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you for being amazing. You all just rock. Okay, I'll see you all soon. Thanks everyone.